Most people in life are looking at how do I make a life worth living and a retirement worth having. In my life, at the present moment, I am homeless. I'm a traveler in life. I'm a traveler in the world. I'm an adventurer. I'm an explorer. And I'm a discoverer of things. When I say this, it's no different than what the United States president is talking about, that he honors the dreamers. And we have a marvelous song from my childhood, from the Muppets and Kermit the Frog, about the dreamers. And we call it the Rainbow Connection. But I can't say I'm a perfect Jim Henson fan, but what I can tell you is those Muppets gave me a lot of laughter as a kid, and it was one of the shows that I was actually allowed to watch. Now, just sharing that little bit of information makes me what? Sharing information with you. When you talk to an intimate relation, you share information with them. And that information is generally confidential because of the nature and context of, well, the relationship. Because typically in life, most of the time in life, we are having one-on-one connections. And what I mean by that is that when we're talking to someone on the phone, it's a one-on-one connection, unless there's someone illegally and morally listening to our conversation, because there's a law that protects us from that. Now, what I'm also talking about is that when we go out in the business community, we might go to a large networking event, we might go out to solicit business, as which is our responsibility for any small business, and any owner of a business cannot be that other word worldly discriminating. And I'll talk more about that in another time. But I guess what I'm saying is that when we go to those events, we start to align ourselves with people who have the same souls, the same ideology, the same concept of reality, and the same understanding of business in our community. And every community is totally different by how they run those things. They might have chambers of commerce. They might have unique networking groups like the national and international BNI groups, but openly what really happens after that and what is promoted by all groups of networking is get together with people in one-on-one. Talk to them by phone, talk to them by Skype, talk to them by video, talk to them in person, talk to them for God's sakes over lunch. It's a great way to learn about people. I had some of the best conversation with some ladies that I met in a small group. I love one gal so much, and I fell in love with her in a way that doesn't make sense to people. She's totally married to a teacher, no problem. She's a complete devout Christian, and you can see it. She shines like the sun. But I loved that conversation with her because it was so authentic, so real, so credible, and it was one of the best conversations of my entire business life. And I really miss that gal. She left the group, went on to do other things, and I encouraged her to do what she needed to do for her family and for her business in life. But the truth is, in life, we meet people like that who transform us, who change us, and who ruin us, too. You have to decide, are you a transformer of people, or are you a transgressor of people? A transformer of people is always honest, forthright, and true. And he picks and chooses when and where he has conversations of different topics and different issues and different opinions, especially if it's something that impacts another person's life. A transgressor on life is someone who interferes constantly and plays games constantly and is always trying to lie, steal, cheat, and manipulate their own life into something better, but they never quite get there. It doesn't matter if they make some real successes, they never quite get there. It's never a tangible thing for them because they're stealing from the house of God. And a transgressor will steal records. A transgressor will abuse them. A transgressor will abuse people. A transgressor will sexually assault people and try to get away with it. A transgressor is not you, hopefully. But what I'm saying is that we have governing laws and governing people for our community and our country and our land. And some of the most important resources of all America are being abused by foreigners from a different place. And they do it because they want to take over our community, they want to take over our technology, they want to take over our gasoline, they want to take over our transportation, they want to take over our hotels and what used to be called lodging. But what I'm saying is we have to be thoughtful and careful about everything in our life. Because one misstep in a relationship can blow it. One bad day by some person can show it. And when it comes to real love, real relationships, real authentic friendships in business, professional, and personal life, or intimate life, which is the most important and significant of our whole lifetime, we have to include the Lord. We also have to know where our boundaries begin and end. Your boundaries on your life are yours. Someone else's boundaries on their life is theirs. But if you did something to harm someone's life and then you're trying to cover up for it by shitting all over that person's life, or it's because someone advised you, you screwed your life. The point of my talk today is not about how to build a one-on-one business. The point of my talk today, or have one-on-one conversations, the point of my talk today is say, look, you have responsibility to the relationships that you build. And you have to be thoughtful and careful and artful and tactful and targeting in who you interact with. Because somebody could look great on the outside as a package, but be shit on the inside in front of the house of the Lord.